of Lazarus. Bound hand and foot with a napkin. Jesus said unto them, loose him. Amen. If I can use for a theme for a few moments. Aim for a theme for a few moments. Let's get it together. One of the indictments on many of our evangelism and to accept Christ and to stop what you're doing at the altar. But when they left the sanctuary, when they go back to their homes and their communities, when they're surrounded by the same things that they left before they came to the altar, there is no voice. There is no accountability. There is no one to make sure that the change that you said happened now commits to later. In our text, we will find that there is a man named Jesus who Jesus loved like a friend, loved like a brother. Jesus allowed this man to die because he knew that when his dying would not be for him to die, but would be for the glory of God. Mary and Martha would not accept this. They struggled to accept this because they wanted Jesus to treat Lazarus like he treated everyone else. The people that Jesus didn't know, the people who were strangers, Jesus would heal them. He would give them sight. He would fix their problems. He would give them words. But it seemed like the one that he loved, he let die. Mary could not accept this because, like many of us in our lives, we see God work on the behalf of everyone else. But it seems the one that he says, I'm your friend and you love me. It seems he allows us to go through things that if it doesn't kill us, it brings us to the point of near death. Jesus arrives on the scene and tells them that I've come to pray, not because I don't believe what's about to happen, but I'm praying for the belief of those that are looking, those that are listening. Every now and then we have to notice and we have to realize that there are some things that need to be done in the sight of the public, not because it needs to be a spectacle, but because someone is always watching for faith. Someone is always listening for faith. Someone is always looking for a point that I can connect with that I won't know. It could not be a mere man. It could not be a mere human. It could not be a mere, no, this has to be a move and an experience from God. Jesus prays, and the text says, he then says, Lazarus, come forth. This was the first call of the text because he did not call for anyone. He did not just plainly and blanketly, universally say, come forth. Because if he did that, being who he was, everything in the cemetery would have risen and come forth. But he said specifically, Lazarus, come forth. There are times that God will make calls, and he's not calling for your neighbor, for your brother, for your sister. He's not calling for your friend. He's not calling for a committee, but he's calling you to do a work at a specific time in a specific place. Lazarus, being dead, being clinically, medically proven dead, then rises and comes forth. The text says that he comes forth with still bound with his grave clothes and his face still covered with a napkin. He then makes the second call and he tells those who were around, the same people who bound him, the same people who watched him die, the same people who buried him. He then calls them and says, now I want you to come and loose him. And the next thing is, after you see change in someone, after you see when they have answered the call, then they have to be loosed from the thing that they were once bound with. And he then said that I want you to do it because you know this man. You lived with him. You talked to him. You had relationship with him. And if I have a stranger come and do it, you might say it's not the same person. But I need you to come and loosen so that you can bear witness that the same one who is dead is now alive. The same one who is lost is now alive. The same one who is dark has now brought to life. You need to bear personal accountability and witness that what I'm doing in the life of those I call, I need there to be witnesses around. And then he makes the third call. He says, after he comes and after you lose him, then I need you to let him go. I need you to send him. I need you to not keep him in the place where you buried him. I need you to not watch and not talk about, but now I need you to let him go into society. Let him go into the community. Let him go into the family. I need other people to see that the thing that I'm doing is one person's life. And I did it before. And then we have to be accountable for our role. Our role is to witness. Our role is to loose. And our role is to set. Let's get it together.
gonna get myself together.